हरे कृष्णा। आज के इस पुण्य अवसर पर हमारे साथ जुड़ रहे देश के संस्कृति मंत्री
प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द इस्कॉन ब्यूरो रिस्पेक्टेड मिस्टर गोपाल कृष्ण गोस्वामी एंड ऑल आवर फ्रेंड्स Krishna devotees who have joined us on this sacred occasion from different countries across the world. Day before yesterday, we celebrated Janmashtami, the birth of Krishna, and today we are celebrating the 125th birth anniversary of Srila Prabhupada ji. This is like experiencing at the same time the happiness and satisfaction that we get from meditation. It is this emotion that millions of followers of Srila Prabhupada Swami and millions of Krishna devotees are feeling and experiencing today. I can see all of you on the screen in front of me, devotees from different countries. It feels like hundreds of thousands of minds are united with one emotion. Hundreds of thousands of bodies are linked with each other through a common consciousness. This is that Krishna consciousness, the awareness and light of which Prabhupada Swamiji spread across the world. Friends, we all know that Prabhupada Swami was a charismatic Krishna devotee, but he was also at the same time a great patriot of India. He took part in India's freedom struggle. He even refused to take his diploma from the Scottish College to support the non-cooperation movement. Today, it is a happy coincidence that the 125th birth anniversary of such a great patriot is taking place at a time when India is celebrating Amrit Mahotsav, the 75th anniversary of its independence. Srila Prabhupada Swami used to always say that the reason he traveled to different countries of the world was because he wanted to share with the world India's invaluable treasure. The spirit of India's knowledge and science, our life culture and traditions, the spirit of these have always been Atha Bhut Dayam Prati. This means only for living beings, only for the welfare of all living beings. The last mantra of our ceremonial rituals is always Idam Namamam. This means, this is not mine. This is for the entire universe. This is for the benefit of all creation. Therefore, seeing in him the potential, the respected Guru of Swamiji, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, instructed him to take India's thought process and philosophy to the world. Srila Prabhupada ji made his guru's instructions his mission, and the results of his devotion and hard work can now be seen in every corner of the world. During this event, that represents the elixir of the energy of India's freedom. India too, with its slogan, inclusive efforts for collective gain with everyone's trust, has made such determined decisions a basis for its onward journey. At the heart of our resolve, the very basis for our targets, is the spirit of global welfare. And all of you are aware how important collective efforts are for us to fulfill these goals of ours. If Prabhupada ji alone was able to give so much to the world, then when we all work together with his blessings, you can imagine what we can achieve. We will definitely reach that peak of human consciousness which will enable us to play an even greater role in the world and spread the message of love to every human being. Friends, yoga is an example that demonstrates how much India can give the world for the benefit of humanity. We can see today that across the world, our yoga traditions are becoming popular. We are resolved to ensure that the entire world benefits from the sustainable lifestyle that we follow in India, from sciences that we have, like Ayurveda. India has made the mantra of self-sufficiency, that Srila Prabhupada ji often used to discuss, its mission. And the country is moving forward in that direction. Often, when I talk about our goals to achieve a self-sufficient India and to make in India, I give my officials and businessmen the example of the success of the ISKCON movement. Whenever we go to another country, and when people greet us there with a Hare Krishna, then we feel such a great feeling of belonging. We feel such pride. Just imagine when people have the same feeling of affinity for Made in India products, how we will feel. Learning from ISKCON, we can achieve these goals as well. Friends, Lord Krishna had said to Arjun, Nahi gyanen sadasham pavitram hi vidyate. This means that nothing is as pure as knowledge. After giving this supremacy, this importance to knowledge, he said one other thing. Mayeva man adhastasva, mayi buddhim niveshe. This means that after acquiring knowledge and science, we must dedicate our minds and intellect to Krishna. We must dedicate them to devotion to him. This belief, this strength too, is a kind of yoga, which has been described in the 12th chapter of the Gita as a bhakti yoga. And this bhakti yoga is very powerful. India's history too bears witness to this. When India was stuck in the deep pit of slavery, the India that was suffering from injustice, atrocities and exploitation was not able to focus on its knowledge and power. Then it was this devotion that kept India's consciousness alive and kept India's identity intact.
Today,
scholars try to assess that if it wasn't for the social revolution during the era of bhakti, we don't know where India would be today and in what form. However, in those difficult times, great saints like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu brought our society together with the spirit of bhakti and gifted us with the mantra of Vishwas and Atma Vishwas, which means faith and self-confidence, faith-based discrimination, social superiority and inferiority, the privileged and the unprivileged. Bhakti removed all of these and established a direct relation between living beings and God. Friends, if you study the history of India, you will discover that in order to maintain this connection to bhakti, all through the different eras and times, many rishis and maharishis and sages came into the society. At one time, a sage like Swami Vivekananda came into our society, who took our knowledge of the Vedic scriptures to the West. Similarly, when it was time to gift the world with Bhakti Yoga, it was Srila Prabhupada and ISKCON who took on the responsibility. He worked towards bringing Bhakti Vedanta together with the consciousness of the world. This was no ordinary work. He started the ISKCON mission at the age of around 70, at a time when most people start decreasing their scope of daily work and tasks. This is an inspiration for our society and for each person. Oftentimes we see people say, I'm too old now, or I would have done a lot, or now is not the right age for all this work. But Prabhupada Swami always remained active towards his resolves from childhood right through his entire life. Prabhupada ji sailed on a ship to America, and at that time with hardly a penny in his pocket, and all he had was the Gita and the Srimad Bhagavat as his wealth. On the way, he even had two heart attacks. This is during his trip. When he arrived in New York, he had no means of getting a meal and no place to stay. But in the next 11 years, what the world witnessed is, if I were to use the words of Honorable Atalji, what Honorable Atalji said about him was, what he has done was nothing less than a miracle. Today, there are hundreds of ISKCON temples and several gurukuls in various countries across the world that keep the Indian culture alive. ISKCON has taught the world that in India, faith, astha, means exaltation, enthusiasm, and exhilaration, and faith in humanity. Today, often in countries across the world, we can see people doing kirtan dressed in Indian attire. Their clothes are simple. They have musical instruments like dholak and manjira in their hand, and they are singing songs of Lord Krishna, and we can see that these devotees are filled with inner peace. Onlookers might think that maybe this is a festival or some kind of special function, but here in our society, this kirtan, this function, and singing devotional songs are an integral part of our lives. This joyous form of faith has constantly been attracting people all over the world, and this happiness is giving new hope to this stress-ridden world. Friends, in the Gita, Lord Krishna says, Advesta Sarva Bhutanam Maitraha Karuna Ivacha Nirmamo Nirhankara Sama Dukh Sukh Kshami, meaning that who loves life form, has a feeling of compassion and affection for them, doesn't hold a grudge against anyone, is God's beloved. It is this very mantra that has been the basis of India's thinking for thousands of years. And the base of this thinking has been done by our temples. ISKCON temples have emerged as the modern center of this very tradition. I remember when there was an earthquake in the Kutch region, how the people of ISKCON came forward to serve the people. Whenever our country has faced any calamity, whether it is the tragedy in Uttarakhand or the destruction caused by cyclones in Odisha and Bengal, ISKCON has supported the society. Even during the corona pandemic, you have been always arranging for food and other essentials for patients, their family members, and immigrants. Besides the pandemic also, you have been relentlessly providing food and support to hundreds of thousands of poor. I am regularly updated about how ISKCON has made hospitals for COVID patients and now are also participating in vaccination programs. I express my deep appreciation to ISKCON and all the devotees in ISKCON for your service and sacrifice. Friends, today, with the mantra of Satya Seva or Sadhana, which means truth, service and meditation, not only are you serving Lord Krishna, but are also playing the role of brand ambassadors of Indian ideals and culture to the whole world. India's eternal culture or sacrament is Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha, Sarve Santu Nirmayaha. This thinking has become the resolve of you and of hundreds of thousands of people through ISKCON. Love for the Lord and to see God in living beings is the only path for fulfillment of this resolve. It is this path that the Lord has told us about in the Vibhuti Yoga chapter. We firmly believe that we will not only practice this mantra of Vasudevaha Sarvam in our lives, but will also make mankind aware of it. With this spirit, I thank you all. Hare Krishna.